Hi, I am so happy you are here and I am beyond excited to talk about why the dialysis clinic is a great place to work. I will also help you decide if this is the right position for you. Real briefly, I just want to give a quick reminder of the type of people that are on dialysis. They are people with end-stage renal disease or kidney failure stage 5, and without dialysis or a kidney transplant, they will die. Before we get too far, I know a lot of you are wondering what is going on with Mrs. Banana and Mr. Dialysis. And in case you missed it, here's a brief recap for you. Oh, I better get that. Oh, hello, Mrs. Banana.
Yeah, sorry Mr. Dialysis broke up with you.
Yeah, I'm dying to know what happens too. Lucky for you, I have some never before seen footage. Take a look.
Yeah, Miss Banana, I know that you'll miss him, but you're not good for Mr. Dialysis anymore. You're going to break his heart. You have too much potassium and you can't handle it anymore. How about I give you Mr. Furosemide's phone number? The one that lives over by Cardiac Corner. Yeah, I'll text you his number.
Yeah, we know we'll be hearing from her again. When making my list of why dialysis is such a great place to work, I found that there were three common themes: teamwork, trust, and teaching. And they all started with a D. To no one's surprise, I was not able to fit everything I love about dialysis into one short video. So I made the executive decision to break this topic up into three parts. For the rest of the video, I will talk about teaching and learning. The next video, I will talk about the amazing dialysis team. And then I will wrap it up by talking about building trust at the dialysis center. You might be thinking, oh, dialysis is boring or the kidneys are easy. Well, you're wrong. The kidneys are complicated. When your kidneys stop working, it affects your whole body. There are secondary diseases that develop as a result of kidney failure. You will become an expert at anemia. You will become an expert at renal osteodystrophy. And where I'm going with this is, as you enter the specialty, you will have to spend time inside and outside of work learning about dialysis theory, pathophysiology, and pharmacology. Not only that, you will need time to learn about fistulas, catheters, diet and fluid restrictions, CMS regulations, and water safety. Yeah, there's a lot of water safety in dialysis. I know what you're thinking, this all sounds awesome. I cannot wait to learn everything dialysis, or maybe I intimidated you a little bit, but that's what I'm here for. I am here to help you learn. I will have in-depth videos about all of these topics. And by learning all of these things, you will be better equipped to teach your patients. You'll be able to help select appropriate interventions for your patients. You will also prevent hospitalizations and infections. And finally, you'll build trust with your patients and your team members. I think this is a good place to stop. My next video will talk about why the dialysis team is one of the best teams you will find out there. I am happy you are here. Keep coming back. Please subscribe, ask questions, and enjoy.